Hello everyone, and welcome back to another CarMaker tutorial. In this video, we will be looking at the first of two CarMaker model extensions illustrated in the online tutorials, namely CarMaker for Simulink. CarMaker for Simulink is a co-simulation between CarMaker and Simulink. There are a couple of benefits of using CarMaker for Simulink. At first, no compilation is required for model changes. Secondly, the changes immediately become active for every single simulation start. And thirdly, the user benefits from using the graphical modeling environment in Simulink in combination with the powerful simulation capabilities of CarMaker. However, with CarMaker for Simulink, there are two drawbacks important to mention. The first and main drawback is the loss in performance due to the computationally intensive nature of this co-simulation. The other drawback is that the co-simulation cannot be used for hardware-in-the-loop applications. Now let's get into working with CarMaker for Simulink. The first step is to open a suitable MATLAB version. You can find information on compatible MATLAB versions in the CarMaker release notes. Once you have navigated into your CarMaker project folder, you will find a folder named SOC_CM4SL or Source CarMaker for Simulink. Navigate into that folder inside of MATLAB. There you will find the CarMaker environment script, cmenv.m. Run the script as the first step. This ensures that all the CarMaker installation paths and dependencies necessary for working with CarMaker for Simulink are added. After executing the CarMaker environment script, you can now start working with CarMaker for Simulink by opening the generic.mdl file. The generic.mdl file is a template model which is provided in every CarMaker project folder. Once you've opened this model, you will note that it contains three main blocks. The block on the left allows you to edit the model configuration, for example, to provide special command line options for the CarMaker virtual vehicle environment. The block in the center contains the various CarMaker or subsystem blocks, and the block on the right allows you to open the CarMaker for Simulink GUI by double-clicking it. After opening it, you can see that the CarMaker for Simulink GUI looks pretty much the same as the regular one. It contains the familiar options, like the ones for starting RPG Movie, Movie in X, RPG Control, and so on. For this example, I will now open RPG Movie. You can start test runs after loading them from the examples folder or from your project. In this case, I'll simply choose the Hockenheim Racetrack test run and then start it. And just as the GUI, the simulation's visualization looks exactly like the one from the CarMaker standalone version. The important difference, however, is that in this particular co-simulation, CarMaker is the slave and Simulink is the master. You can observe the simulation time at the bottom panel of Simulink. Some more pieces of information about the CarMaker block and CarMaker for Simulink have to be mentioned. At first, the CarMaker block is the one located in the center, and it is always executed with a fixed step size of 1 millisecond, independent of the rest of the model. Also, the CarMaker block typically, by default, contains a chain of individual blocks. When Simulink executes CarMaker, all blocks of this CarMaker blockchain must be executed in order and exactly once. Therefore, it is important to know that replacing existing CarMaker functionality with additional Simulink blocks can be done either by overriding existing signals or by adding blocks from the CarMaker for Simulink block set. It should, however, not be done by replacing, removing, or reordering the CarMaker blocks themselves. Another important point to note is the presence of the sync in and sync out ports. These ports guarantee a proper order of execution of the CarMaker blocks. They allow you to choose exactly when a CarMaker dictionary variable is accessed, while using the various blocks from the CarMaker for Simulink block set. You can now access the blocks from the CarMaker for Simulink block set by navigating to the Simulink library browser. Inside the Simulink library browser, select the CarMaker for Simulink block set to obtain a view of the available blocks. By the way, a short description of each of these blocks pops up after positioning the mouse cursor on top of the block. One of the most commonly used blocks is readcmdict. It allows you to read a quantity from the CarMaker data dictionary. With the defined cmdict block, on the other hand, you can define an entirely new quantity in the CarMaker's data dictionary. Part of this definition process may also be to assign a certain data type and unit. In order to write a quantity, you can use the writeCMDict block. Please note that not all quantities in the CarMaker data dictionary can be overwritten. Another way to interact with CarMaker is to access parameters from the CarMaker info files. In the Simulink environment, this can be accomplished with the readCM parameter block. Let's now have a quick look at an example on how to integrate your own algorithms and blocks into the model. For driver assistance system algorithms, the vehicle control block is the way to go. As the name implies, inside this block, you have access to the signals which are used to control the vehicle. This includes parameters like brake, gas, steering angle, and similar. In this case, I want to implement an algorithm which automatically activates the indicators as soon as the steering wheel angle exceeds a certain threshold. Please also make sure to terminate the internal indicator signals of CarMaker. And now we can already start the simulation. Let's switch over to IPG Movie and there you can observe how the indicator of the vehicle is activated on the appropriate side, depending on the steering wheel angle as well. By the way, inside the Simulink model, multiple different models and functionalities can be implemented in the CarMaker at the same time. You could, for example, add another control model for emergency brake maneuvers, flashing the brake lights. Let's now do that real quick. Let's save and run the simulation again. There you go. The second subsystem just activated. Extending the Simulink model in CarMaker for Simulink typically involves integration of controller models into the generic template and therein into the vehicle control block. There are, however, a couple of exceptions. If you, for example, would like to set up a brake control unit, you can use the template Hydraulic Brake Control Unit ESP. It is available inside the CarMaker installation folder or inside the source CM4SL folder of your project. This template also allows you to integrate your own ABS or ESP. Another exemplary exception is if you want to integrate a powertrain-related control unit. In this case, you can use the PT control model. As we are slowly coming to an end, let me repeat two important points. Never delete one of the CarMaker blocks. Just terminate the output. And provide all the signals that the CarMaker model delivers to the bus. You can find more information on the required interface signals for each model class in the reference manual. You may also want to have a look at the product examples: user brake, user powertrain, user steer, and so on, for implementing the respective subsystems. To replace the entire CarMaker vehicle model, please refer to the generic user vehicle.mdl. In certain cases, it may be necessary to disable the internal model selection in CarMaker. This can be done by setting the model selection in the vehicle GUI to model manager off.